Right. Okay. Thank you. Okay, class, today we are going to do ATM. ATM networks. The first is, what is ATM? ATM stands for asynchronous transfer mode. It is a switching technique that uses time division multiplexing, that is TDM, for data communications. ये networks की कुछ names हैं, layers हैं जो मैं अभी आपको बताऊंगी. सेकेंड, ATM networks, ये आपको ऐसे याद करने पड़ेंगे, TDM, time division multiplexing for data communications. Now ATM networks are connection oriented networks. For cell relay that supports voice, video and data communications, it encodes data into small fixed size cells so that they are suitable for TDM and transmits them over a physical medium. The size of an ATM cell is 53 bytes, 5 byte header and 48 byte payload. There are two different cell formats, usual network interface and network interface. The below image represents the functional reference model of the asynchronous transfer mode. Now, what is the benefits of ATM networks? First, it provides the dynamic bandwidth that is particularly suited for bursty traffic. Second, since all the data are encoded into identical cells, data transmission is simple, uniform and predictable. Uniform packet size ensures that mixed traffic is handled efficiently. Small sized header reduces packet overload, thus ensuring effective bandwidth usage. ATM networks are scalable both in size and speed. Now, ATM reference model comprises of three layers. Hello. There are three layers. The first is a physical layer. This layer corresponds to physical layer of OSI model. At this layer, the cells are converted into bit streams and transmitted over the physical medium. This layer has two sublayers: PMD sublayer, that is the physical medium dependent, and second is TC, transmission convergence sublayer. Second is the ATM layer. This layer is comparable to data link layer of OSI model. It accepts the 48 byte segments from the upper layer, adds a 5 byte header to each segment, and converts into 53 byte cells. This layer is responsible for routing of each cell, traffic management, multiplexing, and switching. ATM adaptation layer. Third is the ATM adaptation layer. This layer corresponds to network layer of OSI model. It provides facilities to the existing packet switch networks to connect to the ATM network and uses its services. It accepts the data and converts them into fixed size segments. The transmissions can be of fixed and variable data rate. This layer has two sublayers: convergence sublayer and segmentation and reassembly sublayer. Next are the ATM endpoints. It contains ATM network interface adapter. Examples kya aayenge endpoints ke? Workstation, routers, codecs, LAN switches, etc. फिर आपका आता है ATM switch. It transmits cell through the ATM networks. It accepts the incoming cells from ATM endpoints or another switch NNI, updates cell header and retransmits cell towards destination. अब आती है इसकी working कैसे है? Why ATM networks? Driven by the integration of services and performance requirements of both telephony and the data networking, broadband integrated services vision. Second, आपका telephone network support करता है a single quality of service and is expensive to boot. Third, internet supports no quality of service but is flexible and cheap. ATM networks were meant to support a range of service qualities at a reasonable cost, intended to subsume both the telephone network and the internet. Now, ये एक तरीके से इंटरनेशनल टेलीकम्युनिकेशन यूनियन है, दैट स्टैंडर्ड सेक्शन एफिशिएंट फॉर कॉल रिले एंड इट ट्रांसमिट्स ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन इंक्लूडिंग मल्टीपल सर्विस टाइप सच एज डाटा, वीडियो और वॉइस, व्हिच इज कन्वेड इन स्मॉल फिक्स साइज पैकेट दैट इज कॉल्ड सेल्स. एंड फिर क्या होता है, जो सेल्स हैं आर ट्रांसमिटेड asynchronously and the network is connection oriented. ATM is a technology which has some event in the development of broadband ISDN in 1970s and 1980s, which can be considered an evolution of packet switching. Each cell is 53 byte long, 5 bytes header and 48 bytes payload, jo maine abhi discuss kiya tha recently. So making an ATM call require first sending a message to set up a connection. Subsequently, all cells follow the same path to destination. It can handle both constant rate traffic and variable rate traffic. Thus, it can carry multiple types of traffic with end-to-end quality of service. ATM is independent of transmission medium, they may be sent on a wire or fiber by themselves, or they may also be packaged inside the payload of other carrier systems. ATM networks use packet or cell switching with virtual circuits, and it is a design that helps in the implementation of high performance multimedia networking. आप बताइए जो ATM cell का format कैसे होगा कि as information is transmitted in ATM in the form of fixed size units that is called cell. As already know कि each cell is 53 bytes की 5 bytes header और 48 bytes payload. ये देखो इस तरीके से इसका format होता है कि header ऐसे है and the 48 byte का payload है. अब मैंने आपको याद है दो सेल फॉर्मेट पढ़ाया था, एक यूनीआई और एनएनआई, अभी रिसेंट डिस्कस किया है मैंने. तो ये आपका फर्स्ट वाला यूनीआई यूएनआई सेल फॉर्मेट है, नेक्स्ट इज एनएनआई सेल फॉर्मेट है. यूएनआई हेडर में क्या है, यूज्ड विद इन प्राइवेट नेटवर्क्स ऑफ एटीएम फॉर कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन एटीएम एंड पॉइंट्स एंड एटीएम स्विचेस. इट इंक्लूड्स द जेनरिक फ्लो कंट्रोल दैट इज द जीएफसी फील्ड. Second, NNI header में क्या होगा, इट इज यूज फॉर द कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन ATM स्विचेस एंड इट डजंट इंक्लूड द जेनरिक फ्लो कंट्रोल. इंस्टेड इट इंक्लूड्स अ वर्चुअल पाथ आइडेंटिफायर व्हिच ऑक्यूपाइज द फर्स्ट 12 बिट्स. अब हम पढ़ेंगे इसकी वर्किंग कैसे होती है ATM की. वर्क ATM स्टैंडर्ड यूजेस टू टाइप्स ऑफ कनेक्शन. इसके अंदर आपके टू टाइप्स ऑफ कनेक्शंस आएंगे, वर्चुअल पाथ कनेक्शंस व्हिच कंसिस्ट ऑफ वर्चुअल चैनल कनेक्शंस बंडल्ड टुगेदर व्हिच इज अ बेसिक यूनिट कैरिंग सिंगल स्ट्रीम ऑफ सेल्स फ्रॉम यूजर टू यूजर. A virtual path can be created end to end across an ATM network as it doesn't route these cells to a particular virtual circuit. In case of major failure, all cells belonging to a particular virtual path are routed the same way through ATM networks, thus helping in faster recovery. Switches connected to subscribers uses both VPIs and VCIs to switch the cells which are virtual path and virtual connection switches that can have different virtual channel connections between them. It's serving the purpose of creating a virtual trunk between the switches which can be handled as a single entity. Its basic operation is straightforward by looking up the connection value in the local translation table, determining the outgoing port of the connection and the new VPI VCI value of the connection on that link. Now ATM versus data networks. ATM is a virtual circuit base. The path is reserved before transmission. While internet protocol is connectionless and end-to-end resource reservation is not possible. RSVP is a new signaling protocol in the internet. ATM sells fixed or small size and trade-off is between voice or data. While your IP packets are of variable size. Next, addressing ATM uses 20 byte global NSAP addresses for signaling and 32 bit locally assigned labels and cells, while IP uses 32 bit global addresses in all packets. ये मैं आपको ऑलरेडी डिस्कस कर चुकी हूँ, ATM adaptation layer, physical layer और ATM layer. अब आती है ATM applications. अगर आपके पास ATM पे फुल फ्लैश वर्किंग नोट आता है, शॉर्ट नोट लिखना, तो आपके पास बहुत सारा मटेरियल है. ATM पे applications होगी, इसकी layers होगी, इसकी working होगी, इसकी definitions होगी, काफी कुछ define कर सकते हो. Now the last is ATM applications. ATM vans. It can be used as a WAN to send cells over long distances. Router serving as an endpoint between ATM network and others networks, which has two stacks of protocol. Second, multimedia virtual private networks and managed services. It helps in managing ATM LAN, voice and video services and is capable of full service virtual private networking, which includes integrated access of multimedia. Frame Relay Backbone. Frame Relay services are used as a networking infrastructure for a range of data services and enabling Frame Relay ATM service to internet networking services. Residential broadband networks. ATM is by choice provides the networking infrastructure for the establishment of residential broadband services in search for highly scalable solutions. And the last point is the carrier infrastructure for telephone and the private line networks. To make more effective use of SONET and SDH fiber infrastructures by building the ATM infrastructure for carrying the telephonic and the private line traffic. So, ye tha aapka ATM ki application. इसी के साथ आपको पूरा एटीएम कंप्लीट होता है. अब नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज बुक में एटीएम के बारे में बहुत कम मेंशन है जो मैंने तुम्हें रेफर की हुई है, सुशीला मदान. तो ये जो मैंने अभी आपको भेजा है नोट्स के थ्रू, इसमें एटीएम अच्छे से डिफाइंड है. बुक में एप्लीकेशंस भी गिवन नहीं है, सिर्फ बुक में लेयर्स लेयर्स गिवन है, ना ही वर्किंग गिवन है. तो एटीएम की एप्लीकेशंस यहाँ से नोट कर लो और एटीएम की वर्किंग भी. नेक्स्ट आपका एक टॉपिक है छोटा सा, नेट NAT, दैट इज नेटवर्क एड्रेस ट्रांसलेशन. थोड़ी सी टेक्निकल टर्म्स हैं मतलब, बट ठीक है, यू आर स्टडिंग ई कॉमर्स तो कुछ टेक्निकल टर्म्स आपको याद करनी पड़ेंगी. तो व्हाट इज नेट, नेट कम्स टू इसकी मतलब नेटवर्क एड्रेस ट्रांसलेशन दैट अलाउज अ सिंगल डिवाइस सच एज राउटर to act as an agent between the internet, that is the public network, and a local or the private network. इसके बीच में एक agent का काम करता है net, that is network address transmission. एक तरीके से router की तरह काम करता है, but act as an agent between the private and the public network. So this group of computers, this means that only a single unique IP address is required to represent an entire group of computers. But the shortage of IP addresses is only one reason to use NAT. The process of NAT, also known as network mask guarding or the IP mask guarding, involves rewriting the source and or destination addresses of IP addresses of IP packets as they pass through a router or firewall. So this is done in order to enable multiple hosts on a private network to access the internet using a single public IP address. Now there are some benefits of the NAT. Like first is it is a practical solution to implementing exhaustion of the IPv4 space. Second, in addition to the convenience and the low cost of NAT, the lack of full bi-directional connectivity can be regarded in some situations as a feature rather than a limitation. So to the extent that the NAT depends on a machine, on a local network to initiate any connection to host on the other side of the router, it prevents malicious activity initiated by outside host from reaching these local hosts. This can enhance the reliability of local systems by stopping worms and enhance privacy by discouraging scams. Many NAT enabled firewalls use this as the core of protection they provide. Now next is the drawbacks of NAT. Host behind a NAT enabled router don't have end-to-end connectivity and cannot offer to support such protocol. Incoming packets cannot reach them. मतलब इस नेटवर्क के बिना आप जब तक ये रूटर को एक तरीके से डायरेक्शन देता है ताकि वो अपने डेस्टिनेशन तक पहुंच सके. अगर NAT काम नहीं करेगा तो जो आपके सेल से जो भी आपका पैकेट है वो डेस्टिनेशन तक नहीं पहुंच पाएगा. तो यूज ऑफ NAT ऑल्सो कॉम्प्लिकेट्स security protocol such as the IP address. तो ये था आपका सारा NAT. हाँ तो नाउ आपका नेक्स्ट टॉपिक आता है हाउ कैन द इंटरनेट बी यूज इन द बिजनेस प्रोसेस. Till early 1990, corporate information systems were often centralized and mainframe based. पहले mainframe computers use करते थे हम लोग. तो for executives and manager desiring to receive immediate information on inventory, sales and financial or purchasing data, तो special programming request in a particular language such as COBOL, COBOL, had to be written. Moreover, the needed information rarely could be provided in the real time. With the emergence of PC-based information networks and the development of improved graphical user interfaces in the mind, 1990s, the concept of enterprise information system was established. Warehousing company through the use of PC-based network, EIS, and the company intranets allowed use to collect data of any category and along with online. Analytical processing, that is OLAP, online analytical processing, OLAP. It could provide vital information to a wider range of the people in the organization, and that too often in the real time. For example, by implementing a highly integrated information system, a company could link together its information system application for customer service, inventory, sales, purchase, and accounting. By doing so, a company could be able to focus on servicing customer needs. For example, a prospective customer may either call a company's toll free line or visit this website to order a product. The computer system, either through a customer service representative or a web screen interface, would then provide information to that customer on his or her individual account. The prices of individual products to be ordered and the availability of product in stock. This way, the company's executives would also know which products are selling well and see the financial results of their daily operations. Both the systems, the call center and the web, would be linked together in real time, and the company's servers would support both customer interfaces. Internet can be used in the following business processes. The first is enterprise resource planning, second customer relationship management, next supply chain management, next selling chain management, procurement, call center solutions. अभी कुछ छह सात टॉपिक हैं, ईआरपी, सीआरएम, सप्लाई चेन मैनेजमेंट, एससीएम. अब इनको डिटेल में डिस्कस करेंगे. कॉल सेंटर सॉल्यूशन आपकी बुक में थर्ड चैप्टर में है. So now we are going to discuss the first point, that is the enterprise resource planning. The business information system that integrate various functions of business are called enterprise resource planning systems. ERP systems originally evolved from manufacturing resource planning system. The applications and other functions of the business, such as finance and accounting, were added to the MRP solutions. The aim kya hai ERP system ka is to integrate the various functions of a business. ERP system integrate many common applications into one system. ERP system is an information system that supports several areas of business by combining a number of applications with a single database that stores all the data by applications. it plays an important role in any organization. All organizations have predetermined objectives and goals to achieve. It is very important for any organization to succeed in achieving these goals and objectives successfully. That all the units and departments should work together this common organization goal. Each department or business function in the organization can have its own goals and objectives, which may be conflicting with the goals of other business functions within the organization. Now there is an example over that. Should not work in isolation. Rather, they should. ERP eliminates information or similar communication links. The transfer of information between the processes is instantaneous. Instant transfer of the information. Next, since the ERP system reduces the delivery cycle to customers at and since the architecture of ERP system is of client server, and since they apply object-oriented technology, the process changes can be easily carried out in a short duration of time. ERP system ensures consistency of operations. ERP system makes the access of information easier by providing the central information repository. तो ये थे आपके ERP के benefits. अब आते हैं कि मैंने आपको बताया pros and cons are always there. तो benefits है तो there are some limitations too. तो अब ERP की कुछ limitations given है यहाँ पे. The first is managers cannot generate custom reports of queries without the help from the programmers, which prevents them from obtaining information quickly. Second, ERP system provide current status only, such as the open orders. Information is often needed to look past the current status to find trends and patterns, which helps in better decision making. And the data in the ERP application is not integrated with other enterprise or divisional system and does not include external intelligence. तो ये तीन आपके क्या थे limitations of ERP. तो इसके साथ आपका ERP खत्म होता है. That is enterprise resource planning. ये तो आपका फर्स्ट टॉपिक था. इसके रिगार्डिंग तीन टॉपिक और हैं, वो हम नेक्स्ट क्लास में डिस्कस करेंगे.